Here we are at part 5-1, my video walkthrough for The Legend of Zelda, A Link's Awakening. We have just left the second dungeon, traveling back through the Ganopa Swamp here. Now that we have the power bracelet, there's all kinds of cool little things that we can pick up off the world map. It's a lot of stuff that we have to do before we can enter the third dungeon, so part 5 may be a bit lengthy. But anyway, here's the first chunk of it. I'm heading north of the little path from the Ganopa Swamp. There's a cave here that has a couple chests in it. I decided to just wait until I could get both the chests before I come in here, because you gotta have the power bracelet to pick that skull up. Very nice! 50 rupees. Then over here on the other side, just jump over the gap, and we got another chest. 20 rupees. I am joyous. Darn like-likes. But anyway, let's just move on here. Try not to jump into the pit like I just did. Now, if you go ahead and jump over the gap there, we'll be on the west side of the cave that led to the Sleepy Mushroom. Now that we got the power bracelet, we can grab the heart container out of here, but you'll have to reset the stone blocks before they'll be in the right place for us to pick it up. Alright! Piece of heart! I think that's number 3. I decided to go ahead and just pass through the cave. Good grief, I find a bunch of those guardian acorns now, don't I? I just don't like the music changes. I like the original music. But anyway, let's go ahead and head to the north here, back on the screen with the moblin with the sword and the shield. If we pick this rock up out of the way, it's got a staircase underneath it, which leads to a strange well. If we use our magic powder, it'll make a little demon come out of the well. Woke him up from a nap. He's gonna get his revenge. Oh no! He's gonna make us carry more magic powder! That's horrible! I know. Look at all this junk that I have to carry around. 40 magic powder. I mean, gee, what am I ever gonna do with all that? But anyway, let's just keep exploring the forest here. Oop, that's not the right way. Let's go to the left and then go to the south. Aha! Inside this treasure chest here, alright, a secret seashell! If I collect a lot of these, something good is bound to happen. Do you really think so, viewers? Do you really think that something good is bound to happen if I collect a lot of those? I don't know. I guess we'll just have to find out, huh? Alright, back in town. Now, I'm not quite ready to drop Bow Wow off yet. Got a few other things I want to go do while I'm towing him around. Over here at the Trinity Game Shop, I decided to go ahead and clear the whole thing out, which I didn't bother showing all that just because it's too much time. So, I'm just going to show me getting Yoshi, because Yoshi's pretty easy to get here. Which, I do think it's humorous that, whenever Bow Wow lands on the little conveyor belt, it slides him around. You notice the chain's getting pulled away from me. But anyway. Yay, we got a Yoshi doll! Aw, it's out of prizes. He's got to close up. Alright. Here's Old Man Yurla's house. I was trying to trigger one of the picture scenes, but I don't guess it'll activate just yet. Probably because I got Bow Wow with me. Yeah, it seems he's kind of a shy guy in person. The Bucket Mouse. Yahoo! I'm fine, and you? Oh, whoops. I didn't actually talk to her. Anyway, let's just move along here. Well, I got some money, I got some stuff I need to get out of the shop. Like the shovel! For the low, low price of 200 rupees. Probably also wouldn't hurt to pick up a stack of bombs. Which, if I remember in the original game, you had to buy the bomb, the shovel, before you could get the bombs. But apparently in this one, you don't. Or maybe because I already unlocked them, because I picked a bomb up from the ghost. Who knows? Doesn't really matter. I got 10 bombs now. That's all that matters. Alright, if we talk to this nice little lady here, the wife of Papa High, we'll give her the Yoshi doll, and she'll give us a ribbon! Alright! Don't know what I'm gonna do with a ribbon, but yeah, it might come in handy. Hey, it's Marin! What's going on? Heading into the little shed here. Wolf, dig rough! Dig, huh? Oh! Apparently Bow Wow can sniff out secret seashells. That's pretty cool. Oh, you want a new accessory? Well, I just so happen to have a ribbon. Trade it for some dog food. Sure, I guess. Alright, a can of dog food. It's full of juicy beef. Cool. Well, I think I seem to remember somebody that liked to collect canned foods. Maybe I should go find him. Aha! I bet this guy liked canned food. Man, he's hysterical. He really wants it. Alright, here you go. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Good grief, he ate the whole thing in one bite. Cool, some bananas. Cool, bananas are good. If we head off to the east a little bit here. Oh, it's a chest. Alright. Very nice, 50 rupees. Alright, that's about all the exploring around that we had in this part. Let's go ahead and return Bow Wow to Madame Meow Meow. That just sounds silly to say. You should try it out there. Returning Bow Wow to Madame Meow Meow. Oh, I guess there is one more thing I had left to do. There's a room out of Dungeon 1 that we weren't able to get into because we didn't have any bombs. Which we got some bombs now, so let's go do it. I like to go to the left, just because I never did before, and so it puts it on my map, and it's the shortest way to get there. Alright. If you remember this area, let's jump over here and bomb this wall. And inside this chest is a secret seashell! Alright! I think that gives me like 3 or 4 or something. 4 of them. Excellent. That's a lot, right? I got a lot of them, right? Nothing good's happened yet, though. Alright, now we're ready to head back to town. I do kind of like running around with the chain chomp, though. Just eating random enemies. You don't get items if you eat stuff, though. But anyway, I'll see you all next time.